Hello friends, so in this video we are gonna learn a new concept of finding the analytic function whose real part is given in polar form. So now for that we will assume one analytic function in polar form. So let's say w, that is function of z, is analytic function which is given by u plus I v, where u is the real part of analytic function and v is the imaginary part of analytic function in terms of r and theta, that is in polar form. Now to get the analytic function f of z when real part, that is only u, is given but v is not given, then how to get it? So we are gonna follow certain steps for it. So in step number one, we are gonna find out the value of dou u by dou r and dou u by dou theta from the value of u. Next, once we get dou u by dou r and dou u by dou theta, we are gonna use the Cauchy-Riemann equation in polar form, because f of z is said to be analytic function. So here I'll say by Cauchy-Riemann equation, we will get dou u by dou r as 1 upon r dou v by dou theta. So if I use this Cauchy-Riemann equation, then I have value of dou u by dou r. So I'll put that value here. I'll take this 1 by r or this r on other side, it will multiply here, and then we will get value of dou v by dou theta. And then by the method of variable separation and by integrating both sides, we will get the value of v. And once we get the value of v, we will put that value of v and u in this function and we will get the value of f of z. It's so simple. So to understand this concept, I'm gonna take one numerical. So here we have a numerical where u is given as minus r cube sine 3 theta, and we have to find out the analytic function whose real part is u. So here let's see how we are doing it. So from u we will get the value of dou u by dou r and dou u by dou theta. So therefore u is equal to minus r cube sine of 3 theta. Let's find out dou u by dou r. For that we'll differentiate this u with respect to r partially. So sine 3 theta as it is, and the derivative of r cube is 3 r square minus sine as it is. So we got the value as minus 3 r square sine 3 theta. Similarly, dou u by dou theta is partial differentiation of this u with respect to theta. So minus r cube as it is, sine 3 theta will become cos 3 theta into 3. Next, we got these two values. So we are going to use the Cauchy-Riemann equation since f of z is analytic. So here I'll say, therefore, by Cauchy-Riemann equation, we'll get dou u by dou r is equal to 1 upon r dou v by dou theta, where the value of dou u by dou r is this. So here I'll write it down, minus 3 r square sine 3 theta is equal to 1 by r dou v by dou theta. So if I'll take this r on left hand side, then we will get minus 3 r cube sine of 3 theta is equal to dou v by dou theta. Now to get the value of v, I'll send this theta on other side. So we will get this dou v is equal to minus 3 r cube sin 3 theta d theta. Now we'll integrate both sides. So we will get v equal to minus 3 r cube constant as it is, and the integration of sin 3 theta is minus cos 3 theta upon 3 plus c. So by cancelling this 3, we will get r cube cos of 3 theta plus c as the value of v. So we got the value of v. We have value of u which is given in the problem. Now we'll take these two values and we will put in f of z to get the analytic function. So here I'll say, therefore, f of z is equal to u plus iv. So which is equal to, u is given as minus r cube sine 3 theta plus I, v is given as r cube cos of 3 theta and constant of integration. Now, what we'll do is, instead of this minus term, we can write down this as I square, because we can take I common from this first two terms if we produce I over here. So here I'll say it is I square r cube sine of 3 theta plus I r cube cos of 3 theta plus c. Now I will take I common from first two terms, r cube common, and in bracket we will get cos of 3 theta from here, and here we will get plus I sine of 3 theta plus c. Now we know that cos 3 theta plus I sine 3 theta is e raised to I 3 theta plus c. So here I am using the exponential form of complex number, that is e raised to I theta is cos theta plus I sine theta. So my angle was 3 theta, so I got e raised to I 3 theta. Now I as it is, I can take this cube common, and in bracket we will get r e raised to I theta 3 outside plus c. And guys, we know that this r e raised to I theta is nothing but the exponential form of complex number z. So we can say that it is equal to I, this bracket is z, that is z cube plus c, and here we got the value of analytic function f of z. Thank you.